Hi, this is Jeff with Mount Baker Mining and Metals. And today I'm real excited to run a sample that we have of tailings. And this sample of tailings is from a gold cube concentrator that's been run through that concentrator and got maybe a couple grams of gold out of it. And I was pretty impressed. The gold cube got a good amount of fines in there from the ore. But what we're gonna be testing today is to run this sample through the shaker table and see if we can recover any fine gold which the gold cube missed. So we'll go ahead and fire up the table and see what we can recover. Alright, we've reached the end of the sample run and I'm brushing the table down, which is what you do after you're done for the day. And we'll go ahead and see if there's any gold as we brush it down, and then I'll also pan out the concentrate afterward. Oh, look at that! Man, that is some real fine gold. See it all on that leading edge right in front, and then there's a silver line behind it, and there's even more if you can see it down here. Let me turn the table off for just a second. Wow, you see all these fines. Working down, working off that last little bit of heavy material, and we'll swirl it around and see if there's much gold in there. Let me give it one more. I finished panning down the concentrate from the shaker table, and I'll show you here. There's some really fine gold, about sub 200-300 mesh, maybe the size of, I don't know, talcum powder or so, on that crest. And what I was really surprised about, in addition to getting the gold, was how much other heavy metals were in this sample that the table captured. And this whole pan is full of sulfides and other metals. I'm not even sure what they are. It might be silver or something else. But a lot of material from a 139-pound sample. So I'd say this test is a success. We saw that the table can get more gold than the gold cube can, and a little bit finer, along with all the other metals that were in the ore. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.